एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? सो आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर डूइंग गुड, ऑल आर सेफ एंड एज इफ यू आर न्यू टू दिस चैनल देन यू शुड नो दैट हाउ व्हाट एग्जैक्टली वी डू इन दिस वीडियो. सो इन दिस टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द 10 इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस फॉर योर टीसीयूटी एग्जाम. दिस इज योर सेट नंबर 12, सो यू कैन प्रेफर ऑल द प्रीवियस सेट ऑल्सो सो दैट ऑल क्वेश्चंस आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द एग्जाम. So all will help you. And what will we do here? Whenever you will see the question on the screen, you have to pause the video, try to solve it. If you could solve, that's really great. If you couldn't solve, that's also okay. You can at least you can think, yes, I have tried. And this is just like it will have, you will have a practice. Okay. So yes, this is what we have to do. So we will directly jump on the questions now. Here is your question number one on the screen. Let's see. Let's try to solve this one. What are they saying in this question? The mark price of a mustard oil is 25% more than the cost price. At what percentage less than the mark price should it be sold to have a no profit and no loss? So if the cost price is equals to 100, then they are saying that the mark price is a 25% more than it. So mark price will be 25% more, means it will be 125%. And at what percent less than the mark price should be sold so that there won't be any profit or loss. So if I have to sold at what percent? So if I do not require any profit and loss, that means I should sold it at on the CP. That means discount should be 25 rupees, is it? If I give the discount of 25 and 125, I will sell at 100 rupees. So there will be no profit, no loss. So they are saying that at what percent less than the mark price? So then the mark price, that means it will be what than the mark price? So 125 out of 125. So what should be the discount? That means at what percent it should be sold the less. So 25 ones are 25. Fives are, that means 1 by 5 is a, it should sold at 20% less amount so that there won't be any profit or loss. So answer will be 20% less. That's it, easier. Now let's solve the question number 2. It is, the question number 2 is here on the screen. You can pause the video and then try to solve it. What are they saying here? Rupees 1200 divided among PQR. P gets half of total Q and R received. So how much P received? Half of the Q and R, means Q plus 2 by R. And Q gets 1/3 of the amount received by P and R. So Q gets how much? 1/3 of the P and R. So if you get this equation, what will be this equation? 2P is equals to Q plus R. And this will be 3Q is equals to P plus R. So can I write down this two equation as a 2P is equals to Q plus R and this P is equals to 3Q minus R. So if I solve this equation, if you add this equation, this will be plus plus. So what will it be? Plus R minus R will get cancelled. 3P is equals to 4Q, right? That means P by Q's ratio is a 4 by 3. If P gets a 4, Q will get a 3. So I can substitute this one in any of the value. So where if I substitute in this first equation, what will it be? 2 times of P, that means 2 times of 4 is equals to Q is a 3 plus R. So R will be what? 2 fours are 8 minus 3, that means 5. So if P gets a 4, Q gets a 3, R gets a 5. So this 1200 will be divided in these 3 persons. So they have asked you what will be the amount received by the R. So this ratio is a PQR's ratio is a 4 is to 3 is to 5. So 4 plus 3. So 4 plus 3, 7. 7 plus 5, 12. Out of 12, R will receive a 5. So what will be received out of 1200? So of course it will be equals to 500. That means R will receive rupees 500. That's it. Easier. Now let's solve the next question. Question number 3 is here on the screen. What are they saying in this question? Let's try to solve. ABC started a business with their investment in the ratio 1 is to 3 is to 5. After 4 months, A invested the same amount as before and B as well as C withdraw half of their investment. They have withdraw half of their investment. Then what is the ratio of their profit at the end of the year? So A, B and C. Now, I know that A has invested 1 for the 4 month and After 4 months, he has invested same amount as before. That means initially he has invested one. So he will invest one more. One plus one new amount will be two for the next 8 months. Is it? Then for the B, what we know that he has invested three for the 4 months and withdraw half. That means remaining will be what? Half means 1.5 for the next 8 months. Similarly for C, he has invested five for 4 months and removing withdrawn half, that means 2.5 into 8 for the next 8 months. So what will it be? 4 ones are 4 plus 16. This will be 12 plus 1.5 into 8. 15 8s are 120 means 12 is 2. 5 4s are 20 plus 25 8s are 200 means it will be 20. So how much it will be? 20 is 2, 24 is 240. That means 4 5s are 4 6s are 4 10s are. So your answer will be 5 is to 6 is to 10. Option number D is the answer. Easier. Now let's jump on the question number 4. Here is the question number 4. What are they saying? In a business, A and C invested amount in the ratio 2 is to 1. And whereas the ratio between A and B is a 3 is to 2. So if total profit is a 1,57,300, how much is the B receipt? So I know that if I have to find out A is to B is to C, then whatever is the common, it should be equal, right? So you can see here easily A is a common. But this A is a 2, this A is a 3. So I will multiply this with the 3 and this with the 2. So it will become a 3 to the 6 is to 3 and this will become a 6 is to 4. That means value of A is to B is to C will be what? A's value is a 6. B's value is a 4, C's value is a 3. So what are they saying? How much B receives? So B will receive 4 by what? 6 plus 4, 10. 10 plus 3, 13. If you add all of them, out of 13, he will receive a 4. So out of 1,57,000, how much will he receive? So 31 ones are 13, there will be 2. 31 twos are, so this was a 3. 31 twos are 26, there will be 1. 13 ones are, so 121 into 4 will be 484 and this 00 as it is. That means B will receive 48,400 out of 1,57,300. He will receive 48,400. That's it. Easier. Now let's jump on the next question. Question number 5 is here. A student multiplied a number by 3 by 5 instead of 5 by 3. What is the percentage error in this? So percentage error will be what? Right minus wrong divided by right into 100. Is it? So what is this? He has multiplied by 3 by 5 instead of 5 by 3. That means you can see that five, right was a 5 by 3 but wrong is a 3 by 5. So whenever such ratios are there, we will multiply this with the denominator or LCM of denominator. LCM of denominator. So LCM of 3 and 5. What is the LCM of 3 and 5? Which is equals to 15. That means we will multiply this equation with the 15. So how much it will be? 3 ones are 3 fives are, means right value was a 25 but wrong value is a 5 threes are 15 means 9. So right 25 minus wrong 9 divided by 25 into 100. 25 ones are 25 fours are and 25 minus 9 is a 16. So 16 fours are 64%. That means the percentage error is the 64%. That's it. Simple. Now let's solve the next one. Question number 6 is here. What are they saying? Vimal invested in a simple interest scheme at the rate of 18% per annum for 2 years. Renu also invested the same sum in a compound interest scheme at the rate of 18% per annum. For the same time period. Means we can see rate of interest is 18% for both of them. Time period is a 2 years for both of them. And even P is also same. But only one is a SI, one is a CI. And what are they saying? The interest amount received by Renu is rupees 259.2 more than the Vimal. Difference is what? Renu is received this much more. That means Renu minus Vimal, that means CI minus SI is equals to what? This was the Vimal, this was the Renu. So difference is equals to given as a 259.2. So what we know, we have a formula. Difference is equals to P into R by 100 ka square. And we need to find out this P. So what is the difference? 259.2. टू विच इज इक्वल्स टू पी इंटू आर इज 18/100 का स्क्वायर, दैट मीन्स 18 × 100 डिवाइड बाय 18 × 100. सो व्हाट विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस पी? अगर ये 100 मल्टीप्लाई हो जाता है तो 2592 इंटू दिस 1230, राइट, 10 यहाँ पे आ गया. तो 18 × 18, इफ यू सॉल्व इट व्हाट विल इट बी? 18 × 1 = 18, देर विल बी 7, 18 × 4 = 72, अगेन 18 × 4 = 72, एंड अगेन दिस वन विल बी व्हाट? 18 × 8 = 144. सो 8 × 1000 विल बी 8000. दैट मीन्स द वैल्यू ऑफ P, that value of X is the 8000 rupees. That's it. Easier. Now let's see the next question. Question number 7 is here. What are they saying in this question number 7? Tina borrowed rupees 4800 at the rate of R% per annum in SI. For the Tina, P is equals to 4800. R is equal to R%. The SI time. And Meena borrowed 5050, 5500 at R plus 5 interest, R plus 5% of interest on in SI. Okay, Meena and Tina borrowed at the amount for 3 year and X year respectively. So for Meena it is a 3 year, means time period for Meena is a 3 years, and for time period for Tina is a X year. So what are they saying? Meena paid the total interest 4125. इसका SI कितना है? 4125. इसका SI कितना है? अननोन है. सो फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ X. Now see, we know these values, right? And by using these Meena's values, simply we can find out the R also, because we have a SI, we have a P, we have a time period, so we can find out the R period. But if we know the R, still can we find out this X? Because see, SI is also unknown, X is also unknown. So when there are two unknown, answer will be cannot be determined. We can find out the R. For understanding purpose, we will solve it. What will be this? SI is equals to PRT by 100. That means SI is a 4125, which is equals to 5500 into R is a R plus 5 into 3 by 100. So you can see this 00 will get cancelled. 11 5s are 11, 3s are 33. There will be 8. 11 7s are 77. 11 5s are, right? Then what will it be? 5 into 7s are and 5 5s are. And again, this 3 will be 3 into 25s are. That means 25 is equals to R plus 5. So you can see R is equals to 20%, right? Now, if you know that ki P is equals to 4800, time period is equal to X, and rate of interest is equal to 20%. And even SI is also unknown. Can you find out this X? No. Answer will be can't be find, cannot be determined. So your answer is option number D, that is cannot be determined. Okay, I hope you are getting this. Now the next one, question number 8 is here. In an examination, 30% of the total students failed in Hindi, 45% failed in English, and 20% failed in both of the subject. Find the percentage of those who passed in the both subject. So this is the question of set theory. So suppose this is of the Hindi and this is of the English, right? So what I know that if how many have failed in Hindi is a 30% and failed in English is a 45%, but failed in both, this is a common part, this common part is a 20%. If this is a 20, then this will be what? If overall Hindi is a 30, out of which this is 30, so this will be 10, like, so 10 plus 20 will be 30, and this will be what? Out of 45, this is a 20, so this will be 25. So total failed will be how much? Total failed will be equals to 10 plus 20 plus 25. That means 55%. Or you can find out total failed is equals to, what is the formula? This total failed in Hindi plus total failed in English minus failed in both of them. This answer will be also 55%. So if failed is equals to 55, then number of passed students will be what? Out of 155 has been failed, so passed will be 45%. That's it. Option number D is the answer. Easier. Now let's solve the next one. Question number 9 is here. Three friends, P, Q, and R, started a partnership business investing money in the ratio 5 is to 4 is to 2, respectively, for a period of 3 years. So you have a ratio of investment. Sorry. So you have a ratio of investment, which is the 5 is to 4 is to 2, right? Of the P, Q, and R. This is the ratio of investment. For a period of 3 years, we know that time period is equals to 3 years. What is the amount received by P as its share in the profit? Ki P ko kitna profit hua hoga? Okay, profit of P is equals to 1. So, total amount invested in the business is 22,000. Now, see, if I have to find out the profit, I will require the investment and time period. So, I have a ratio of investment. But do I have a total investment? No. So, I will require a total investment. If I know the total investment, then I can find out the individual investment of each of the person. So, this is needed. Is it? Then, profit earned at the end of the 3 years is a 3 by 8 of the total investment. Now from this equation, I get the profit because I have to find out the profit of P. So first of all, I should know the investment and I should know the profit also. What is the total profit? Is profit mein se isko kitna mila? Is it? Or else what can we say? Means if we have these two equations, we have to understand ki which is required. Agar mujhe total profit hai, suppose wait, I will explain this question properly. Okay, just a minute. If I can use A and B, then I can find out the answer. Or else, suppose I know the total investment is 22,000. So total investment, see, I have a ratio of investment, I have a time period. So what will be the profit of P? Profit of P will be equals to 5 upon 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 2, 11 into total profit, right? Into total profit. Why is it so? Because I know ki time period to same hai. So this is what I require. So to find out the profit of P, I will require the total profit. So see, by using the first statement, I cannot find out the total profit. But profit earned at the end of 3 years is a 3 by 8 of the total investment. So if I use the first equation, 22,000, and iska 3 by 8 is the total profit, then you can find out it. Then I can find out here profit is equal to what? 3 by 8 of investment. That means 3 by 8 of 22,000. So I can substitute this value here. 5 by 11 into total profit is a 3 by 8 into 22,000. Then I can solve it. 11 ones are 11, 2s are. So it will be 2,000. So how much it will be? 5 threes are 15, 15 twos are 13,000 by 30,000 by 8 will be equals to my profit of P, right? Profit of P. This is what you can find out it. So if we use both of the statement, then also you can find out. Or what is the C? The average amount of profit earned per year is a 2750. So if we know that average as total time period is equals to 3 years. And for 1 year, it is a per year, it is a 2750. So can you find out total profit here also? Total profit will be equals to 2750 into 3. This is also you can find out 0 as it is 3 5s are 15, carry will be 1. 21 plus 1, 22, carry will be 2. 3 9s are 3 2s are 6 plus 2 will be 8. So this is your total profit. Means this one also you can use in this formula because you required this formula. So your answer will be option number B, that is either A and B, ye dono ke dono chahiye, ya fir only C or C are sufficient. If C alone is there, then also you can find out the answer. That will be also enough. But you should know A and B means you should know the total profit. So either option number C means only C gives you the profit, or A and B gives you the profit. So answer will be either A and B or C are sufficient. So this was really important. Okay. And now let's solve the last question. Now this question is quite calculative. इन अ सिटी 35% ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ माइग्रेंट्स, 20% ऑफ हुम आर फ्रॉम रूरल एरियाज. ऑफ द लोकल पॉपुलेशन 48% इज फीमेल, व्हाइल दिस फिगर फॉर रूरल एंड अर्बन माइग्रेंट इज 30% एंड 40% रिस्पेक्टिवली. इफ द टोटल पॉपुलेशन ऑफ द सिटी इज 7,28,400, व्हाट इज द फीमेल पॉपुलेशन? Is it? So first of all, what is the local female? If we find out the local, as I know that 7,28,400, and we know that 48% in a city, 35% of the population is the migrant. If 35% is a migrant, that means 65% will be the population which are not migrant. And out of those, what we know that these are the local population, and out of those local population, 48% are the female. So this one will be the local, this one will be the local number of female. Then out of the rural, if you see, out of this 7,28,400, 35% of the population is the migrant, and out of which 20% are the rural. So इसका 35% these are the migrant, out of which 20% are the rural, and they are saying that this is the rural is a 30% are the female, and इसका 30% are the female. This is for the rural. And if you talk about the urban, then what will it be? As I know that 7,28,400, इसके 35% आर दी माइग्रेंट, आउट ऑफ विच एज आई नो दैट 20% वर दी रूरल, सो रिमेनिंग 80% आर दी अर्बन, एंड आउट ऑफ विच नाउ फीमेल आर 40%. सो इफ यू एड ऑल ऑफ दिस, दिस विल बी द फीमेल पॉपुलेशन. सो इफ यू एड, वॉट विल इट बी? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू कैन सी दिस डबल जीरो विल गेट कैंसल, this double zero will get cancelled, these two zero will get cancelled, this double zero will get cancelled, these two zero will get cancelled. Now what will I do? I have to add all of them. So you can see 7,28,400 is a common in all of them, is it? So if you took 7,28,400 is a common in the first one, I get a 65 into 48 डिवाइड बाय 100, डिवाइड बाय 100, डिवाइड बाय 100. सो डिवाइड बाय 100 भी मैंने कॉमन ले लिया, राइट? इसका 100, इसका 100, इसका 100. प्लस इन द सेकंड ब्रैकेट 35 इनटू 3 टू आर 6. प्लस दिस वन विल बी व्हाट? 35 इनटू 8 फोर आर 32. सो कैन यू ऐड ऑल दिस वैल्यूज नाउ? So if you add, what will we get? This 7,28,400 divided by 100 is as it is. Now if you solve it, 65 into 48, how much it will be? 8 fives are 40, carry will be 4. 8 six are 48, and 5 fours are 20. What will be the sum? 8 plus 4, 12, carry will be 1. 2 plus 3 plus 4, 7, 72. Out of which 7, 2 will be here, 7 will be carry. 6 fours are 24, 24 plus 7 will be 31. That means this one will be the 3120. Plus 35 into 6 will be what? 35 six are 210. Plus 35 into 32, what will 32? What will it be? 35 twos are 70, carry will be 7. 35 threes are 105. 105 plus 7 is a 112. So if you add, what will it be? 3120, 210, 1120. 0, 2 plus 1, 3 plus 2, 5. 1 plus 2 plus 1 will be 4, and 3 plus 1 will be 4. So it will be 4450. सेवन टू एट फोर इंटू फोर 4450 डिवाइड बाय 100. दिस 1010 विल गेट कैंसल्ड. नाउ कैन आई मेक इट मोर शॉर्टर? एज आई टोल्ड यू, दिस इज क्वाइट कैलकुलेटिव. सो कैन वी डू दिस मल्टीप्लीकेशन? 445 इंटू फोर विल बी वॉट? 444. 400 into 4 will be 1600, and 45 fours are will be 180. 1600 and 180 will be 1780, right? So 1780 out of which here will be the zero and 178 will be the carry. Then 4 4 4 4 4 5 into 8. 4 4 5 into 8 कितना आ रहा है? 8 5s are 40, carry will be 4. 8 4s are 32 plus 4 36, carry will be 3. 8 4s are 32 plus 3 will be 35. Yes. So 3 5 6 0 plus 178. 8 plus 0 8, 7 plus 6 13, carry will be 1. 5 plus 1 6 plus 1 7, 3 7 3 8. Out of which now 373 will be the carry. Now 4 4 5 into 2, how much it will be? 890. So 890 plus 373 will be 3 as it is. 9 plus 7 16, carry will be 1. 8 plus 4 12. Out of which 6 3 will be here. Sorry. Three will be here, 126 will be carry. Now 4 4 5 into 7. 4 4 5 into 7 कितना आ रहा? 7 5s are 35, carry will be 3. 7 4s are 20. 8 plus 3 31, carry will be 3. 28 plus 3 will be 31 plus 126, right? Six plus five, 11, carry will be 1 1 2 3 4, 1 1 2 and 3 3 2 4 1, 3 2 4 1 divide by 10 था तो 0 0 will get cancelled, so your answer will be 3 2 4 1 3 8. This is the answer, which is your option number A. So this question was quite calculative, but it was easier, and that's it. This was your last question. So I hope you understood all these questions. If you find out any query in any of the question, you can, or if any other doubt regarding the exam or anything, you can simply ask in the comment box. And if you wish to join our TCET community, you will get access to our live classes, you will get the mock strategies, free resources, number of things. But link is in the description, so you just have to message in the comment box, so you will get the link there. Okay, even link is in the description box also. So that's all. Thank you so much for watching this video. See you in the next part. Bye bye. Take care. Stay safe. Stay tuned.